Welcome to the Faster, Easier, Better show with your hosts LeeSilber and Ellen Goodwin. This podcast is short, fun, and jam-packed with good ideas that you can start using right away. And here's your hosts, Lee and Ellen.
Welcome to the Faster, Easier, Better show. I'm your co-host, Ellen Goodwin, along with my co-host,
LeeSilber.
Hey, Lee, guess what time it is? It's back to school time.
The worst.
Oh, wait, I thought that was like the happiest time of the year for parents.
It's a catch-22. I think the schools now started a week earlier, and in some places around the country, 2 and 3 weeks earlier.
Whoa.
Whereas summer's cut in half. You know, we did an episode recently about just freedom and nothing on your schedule. Those are great days.
Yeah.
When school starts, every weekday is, you know, you got to be somewhere. But on the other hand, the kids are learning. They're, they're with their buddies. I mean, it's not a bad thing, of course. School is good.
Yeah. So what I thought.
Hey, that's profound.
School is good. School is good. Learning is good.
But as Alice Cooper said, school's out for summer. And I really enjoy those summer months of just having fun with the kids, bonding. But once they go off to school, they're in other people's hands.
Right.
Except when they're studying.
Then they're in my world. Yeah.
And I think that's what you want to talk about.
I think that would be a great thing to talk about.
And it's not just kids either.
No, it's anyone.
We should be lifelong learners.
We should be.
And we should be studying. Either you're getting better or you're getting worse.
Or you're not.
So you should be doing something every day to make yourself better, whether it's learning something new or
So I wanted to talk about smart study habits because, you know, yeah, kids are back in school. Adults are back in school. What are some really good ways to make good use of your time so you study effectively, but you don't like use up your whole life studying? So, you have any thoughts?
Well, I'm a believer in, you know, the catch and release, which is like you catch a fish and you put it back out to sea.
Right.
Because I feel like when we take notes, some people go back and look at them and it's good to have them. It's not so much the reviewing of the notes later, it's the act of taking them.
Absolutely.
That makes the information sink in deeper. You got to focus more on what's happening, what the person's saying, what you're reading, so that you're more in the moment. You're learning deeper because you're trying to write down. Now, I know it sounds counterintuitive. You're so fast trying to write notes, you're not listening. But by being more and saying, I don't want to miss anything. I want to make sure
right.
I capture it all. Helps you to be more focused so taking notes. But I'm saying, usually the reviewing of the notes is rare. It's the act of doing it.
Act of taking. Yeah. And what's interesting is. And you couldn't see it, listeners, but Lee was showing typing. And studies have shown that it's better to take your notes, by hand.
I agree.
Because it has to do with the hand-brain connection that you actually absorb more than if you're just inputting it on a computer.
And let me just go one step further and say, just computer or tablet or whatever, it limits, like it's very linear, it's very structured.
Right.
Whereas when you're writing, you could write a mind map, okay, the main point is, and then there's these subpoints, so little lines come out with little bubbles, you know, so
yeah.
The middle bubble, or you draw a picture of something that will, if you're a visual learner, some point that they're making, you know, you can make notes off to the side. It's more flexible, it's more fluid, and it's just more of a fun way to take notes by doing it by hand.
Right.
The downside is it's not digital.
Right, right. But you're not even reviewing it.
That's my point. Those I would.
Yeah.
I'd go back and scan, look at my picture. Oh, that reminds me.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
It's your system. That's the whole crux of my entire being is you've got to find your way.
Mm-hmm.
If your way is typing it in, fine, do it. But if your way, and I'm assuming a lot of people are like this, if your way is to do it with some sort of other technique, go with it.
Yeah, but do something that you don't just sit there and absorb. You are interacting with it in some way.
Right, aren't you always saying to yourself, how does this apply to me? That helps me to put myself in the story. I'm learning something complex that I really...
Uh-huh.
I'm just doing it so I can pass a test. But then when I say, well, how does this personally, how would I use this osmosis or something? And then now that's personal... You know, I feel like, oh, yeah, I get it. When I sweat, the osmosis that goes through my shirt. Now I'm, I remember now.
Exactly. And another thing I just learned this week is when you're studying or when you're learning something new, to go into it with a beginner's mind. You know, don't go in like, okay, I know all this stuff already. No, go in and be looking for what is something that you don't know, that you're like, oh, I thought I knew all this and I didn't. But you just come in with a beginner's mind and just let it come to you.
You know, as a trainer, mm-hmm. I always try and mix up what I teach. You know, I feel no learner left behind. So it's auditory, you know, it's kinesthetic, it's visual, it's everything. It's
right.
Everything. Within an hour, you will have done it, touched it, heard it, seen it, you know, all those things. And in the end, you're, you know, it's the main point, basically,
right.
is what I'm trying to convey. Because a lot of people say, you know, if I go to this 1 hour thing to learn something, I hope I just learned one thing that I can mm-hmm. use. So I'm trying to give them the one thing with a couple of other options for those that it doesn't apply to. But mostly it's focused on the one thing. So when you go in to learn something, what is the most important thing I want to know? What supports it? What's related to it? What are the subsets of it? But knowing the main reasoning behind something, the point, that's what we talk about in design.
Right.
You know, you could use all this different equipment, but if you don't understand the basics, the foundation of what good design is, it doesn't matter if you're using Quark or PageMaker or, and no one uses those anymore, or InDesign or Photoshop, you're not going to do good work because you don't understand the foundation, the fundamentals. Mm-hmm. So the building blocks are important.
Right. And I think the other thing that we would be really, if we neglected this, it would be a bad thing. And that is focus and finding time to focus, because that's when real studying, real learning happens. And the thing is, people think, oh, I'm going to have to focus for 3 hours to study. But no, you don't. You can break your hour. You have an hour time. Break it into 10 minutes. And you just work on small chunks for 10 minutes at a time with a little break in between. You don't have any distractions. You can focus for 10 minutes. I mean, you can quit watching television, get off your phone, turn off the internet, 10 minutes at a time. That's, you know, I think that's where you can get more done.
You know, I'm a big coffee shop guy.
Yes.
Love the coffee shop because you get the caffeine. Focus. I find a nice corner. Focus.
There you go.
And, you know, they can only let me sit there so long before they kick me out. Focus. But finding the right space to do it
absolutely.
Is important, where maybe the coffee shop is too distracting. And you need a quiet place to do it. Maybe it is you're one of those that believes, and maybe rightly, but probably wrong, that you can watch TV, text, talk to someone, and study, and still be just learn it as deeply and as effectively as if you were to just study and got rid of the other things. I'm not saying that you. Some people can. Most people can't.
Most people can't. So, back to school. Study effectively. Study efficiently. Thanks for listening. We'll be back with the next episode next week of the Faster, Easier, Better Show.